Boom. Initial thoughts to CrossFit 6 months in.
Alright guys, welcome back. It's Saturday today. Yesterday I didn't film because it was kind of an unentertaining workout. Even though it was still good, it was my first ever Mary. I believe I got 9 rounds plus another plus 2 pull-ups, so a whole nother round plus 2 pull-ups. It was 5 handstand push-ups, 10 alternating pistol squats, and 15 pull-ups. The hardest part for me, man, was the handstand push-ups, man. I hate being upside down. I'm super uncomfortable. If you guys are new to CrossFit, you probably are too. You probably relate. So this workout was kind of gnarly for me. I was gonna do just push presses with dumbbells, but I just happened to get a skull mat or a skull mat, which was the thin one like that. And I used that, I just set it up, and I was like, you know, I'm just gonna go for it. 5 seconds in, man, I got super nervous. Everyone just went on the wall. My first take on the wall, I just crashed up on it, man. It wasn't pretty. But after, which was why I like this workout, man, I just kept getting back on and just kept getting better and better. Learned how to do kipping, handstand push-ups. So, man, just the more you face your fears, the better you get and the more comfortable you get, man. So that was a big win yesterday. Today's workout, though, is gonna be a pretty spicy one. So I just warmed up. I warmed up on the assault bike. I did 1 minute only feet, 1 minute only arms, and then 1 minute using both, and then 1 minute only feet again, 1 minute only arms. And then for my warm up, I did 8 hang clean to shoulder press with kettlebells, and then I used 25 kettlebells. And then after that, it was 1 minute plank, and after that, it was 5 broad jumps. I did 3 rounds of that. Now I'm doing a little warm up. I'm gonna do like a little EMOM. I'm gonna do 5 hang cleans and then 5 toes or knees to elbow on the rings. The actual workout today is gonna be 2 rounds with a partner, so I don't have a partner. I'm gonna do it all just half. It's gonna be 60 hang power cleans at 135, 60 shoulder to overhead at 135, 30 synchronized bar facing burpees, 30 synchronized toes to bar. So for me, it's gonna be 30, 30, 15, 15, man. I'm gonna do this workout, it looks fun. Usually I do a Saturday, you know, open gym, just more bodybuilding, isolation stuff. Last night, I actually got an arm workout with one of my friends, so I'm good on that, man. I really wanna hit this workout. Super excited, man. Let's get into it.
You're supposed to stop the ribbing, man. That's what happened yesterday.
We'll see how these go. So I'm gonna change it up. I'm gonna do 5 hang power cleans, 5 shoulder to overhead, and then 5 over here.
Back to another commentary, guys. If you're new here, my name is Rodrigo. I'm shots_G. I'm actually new to CrossFit. If you guys have seen my series, the new to CrossFit series, just started about 6 months ago. I just want to jump in here real quick, kind of let you guys know what this video is going to be about. I'm going to be walking you through this workout that I did recently. This is probably a more recent workout I've done, maybe a week prior to this video going up. And I just wanted to talk to you guys about my CrossFit journey so far. I'm 6 months into only doing CrossFit, transitioning over from just functional fitness, like bodybuilding isolation stuff, to just only CrossFit programming and just CrossFit in general, joined a CrossFit box. I'm going to be talking about the physical gains, the mental gains, and then just overall satisfaction. There's some pros, there's some cons. I'm going to be going over all those. And then just overall my satisfaction, how I feel about starting CrossFit, whether or not I think you should start it. If you're new to CrossFit, been thinking about starting CrossFit, or you're just one of those CrossFit haters out there, I used to be the one making fun of the kipping pull-ups and all that until I actually tried them and did them in a workout. I was like, holy crap, this is hard. It actually involves technique, strength. You need that strict strength. But yeah, that's what I'm going to be going over. I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe. Catch you guys in the next one. Yeah. So as you can probably tell by the title of this video, this is my initial thoughts to CrossFit 6 months in, man. I've been in CrossFit for about 6 months now. Only CrossFit consistently, pretty much every day. I'm training either 5 to 6 days a week with one active rest day at the end of the week, or maybe even one active rest day and then one full rest day, just depending on how my body's beat. The reason why I decided to film this today was because I actually took a active rest day today, man. My body is super sore.
All right, man, that's gonna do it for this little portion of the workout. I'm gonna scale it back down to 95 pounds just so I can knock out this workout and have time to practice other stuff at the end. The only reason why I'm doing it at 95 is because my overhead, shoulder to overhead, I need practice for sure. I also don't even know if I can get 135 up. I probably can, but not like in a workout like this, so I'd rather just get the reps in for the overheads with a little bit lighter weight. And then at the end of this, after this, I might practice shoulder to overheads with like a heavier weight, maybe rest 1 to 2 minutes in between sets, just to get used to it, man. I'd rather build that solid foundation, man. Just finding little things here and there that need improvement, man. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. See you guys next time.
Threw a little bit of vitamin C in here, some creatine in here from X-Works, man. Go check them out. But yeah, as you can tell by the title of this video, 6 months into CrossFit.
30 hang power cleans, 30 shoulder to overhead, and I'm gonna be doing 15 burpees, 15 knees to rings.
6 months into CrossFit now. So I'm gonna break it down into three parts. The mentality I've had so far up until this point, the physical changes, and then just overall satisfaction. So we're gonna go the mentality standpoint, physical standpoint, and then satisfaction standpoint. So let's start with the mental standpoint. For me, starting CrossFit was a big hurdle, man. Whenever I go into the gym, I start off with a warm-up, man, get in my zone, really think about my workout, the reps that are coming, and I really focus on trying to make it the hardest part of my day so the rest of my day is easy. Whatever comes at my way, all the stresses, all the, whatever BS that comes your way sometimes, unfortunately, you can handle it. You've already done the hardest part, man. Anything else is easy, whether that's taking on a new task at work, you got some relationship stuff going on, financial stuff going on. You can handle that, and you can handle it because you've already kind of fine-tuned your mind for the rest of the day. And why I say for the rest of the day is because I work out early in the morning, either 5:30 or first thing whenever I wake up. So if you guys have been following the Breakfast Club, I kind of just started saying that because I was working out super early in the morning. Breakfast is my favorite meal, man. Just Breakfast Club training. So I don't know, it's just a little saying I say. So if you're part of the Breakfast Club, drop it down in the comments or go over to my Instagram and let me know you're part of the Breakfast Club. Basically, get up, make that the hardest part of my day, and then go out through the rest of my day. With that being said, going into CrossFit, it was kind of a little hurdle because you're in a group environment. You don't really have headphones on, which I'm usually used to working out with, either headphones or just no headphones at all. But it's not like a class environment. The gym's either usually pretty empty or little to no people. And you just go about your workout, staying focused on yourself. Not really any distractions, I guess. If you pay attention to other people, you can. So going to CrossFit in the class environment for someone telling me what to do, on top of that, a bunch of people around you, on top of that, the competitiveness was, honestly, not gonna lie, it was kind of turning me off in a way. And it was all just myself doing it to myself. First of all, having someone else telling me what to do was kind of weird. Not in the sense that like, oh, I don't know. They don't know what they're doing. Obviously, they're explaining the movements and the intent of the workout. But just trusting someone with your program was kind of a hurdle for me, just considering I was so used to my training split and then also doing other programs from other people I look up to. So kind of just seeing these different workouts every day was like, oh, where are they getting it from? Or how are they coming up with this? So just having that trust, once gaining that trust for them and for the workouts and really pushing yourself to the intent of the workout, whether it was like a strength or just go as fast as you can or push hard on the breathing, that sort of thing, was big, man. That was a big win, just letting go and trusting the process. Another thing was
having all the people around you, you're gonna have a bunch of people. So that can be a pro and a con. For me at first, I'm not gonna lie, it was definitely a con, man. I was paying attention to everyone else around me. I don't know why, I never do that at the normal gym. I'm just in there focused on my workout, but for some reason I would just get distracted in what other people were doing. Obviously that's because some of the movements I couldn't do or some of the movements I was kind of iffy about, so I would like watch them and then I'd compare myself and it was just a shitstorm, man. So that was not good. And then also the competitiveness of it, you know, you start to compare yourself, you want to, on some stuff you can't really move as well or you can't do it, and you start like wanting to do more and then compare yourself and you're like, oh, what the heck. First of all, like, you're in there to better yourself, you're in there to get a good workout and to take care of your overall health. So once you throw that out the window, you're good to go. This is where the pros come in, and it's all just your viewpoint. So what really helped me was kind of just changing my viewpoint and really just stepping into CrossFit itself, man. The CrossFit journey, man. The new to CrossFit, man. I have a whole series, the new to CrossFit, go check it out. Basically, going in there, trusting, looking at your coaches, obviously they look the part, and you know, just getting to know the coaches, getting to know the people behind the box in the gym, really help you to open yourself up and let go and just trust them. Trust them with the movements, trust them to coach you and give you cues on how to get better, trust them with the programming, especially the programming, man. Knowing that you're going to be progressing in all different areas, that you're going to get better, and that each workout has a purpose and an intent. So that's really a huge, huge pro of CrossFit. So the next one was all the people around you. That's also a big pro, because whenever you have, one of the biggest things I've noticed is it's good energy in there all the time, man. Everyone goes in there hyped up, or whether they're nervous about the workout or they know the workout's gonna hurt, everyone's in there getting ready. You're all kind of like, oh, okay, let's do this. Middle of the workout, everyone's just going hard, or beginning of the workout, everyone's going hard. To the end, everyone's going hard. Everyone's pushing each other up until the last person, like, egging them on, like, hey, let's go, let's finish strong. And it's good energy, man. I love that kind of environment, man. Whenever I work out with my buddies, I'm always like yelling, pushing them, and they start doing that to me, and I love it, man. Some people are more shy and timid. I love it, man. I just embrace it. And that's a huge pro about going to CrossFit gym, is that really the community, the energy, and just having other people that are working out with you, kind of suffering and going through something shitty just like you, but you're getting it done, and there's something about that connection that's different than just going to your normal Globo gym, chasing a pump, and then leaving. That has its pros too. I'm gonna do a video whenever I collab with my buddies. I'm gonna be collabing with a few of my buddies that are bodybuilder physique competitors, and we're gonna kinda go over the pros and cons of what they do. And then, because obviously they both have pros and cons, and just like I said, like going in there and just focusing on yourself, that's a good thing too. But the overall community and the energy from everyone working hard is awesome, and nothing else like it. The next point, the competitiveness. Sometimes you need that competitiveness, man. I personally am competitive with myself, with other people. Here and there, I just really have to get in the zone or be mentally ready for it. So since starting CrossFit, at first, I was kind of competitive, but then I kind of realized, like, hey, you need to work on the movements, you need to work on form and stuff. So just focus on yourself, focus on beating yourself, focus on either finishing the workout, pushing through on the workout, pacing, all that sort of thing. Just kind of getting competitive with myself. But then later on, as like a few weeks went by and the months progressed, like getting competitive, man, like trying to push myself, trying to catch people on the workout, or even pushing them and like, hey man, let's go, I'm catching up to you, push it, like, so they can get a better time, and that'll push you too to get a better time yourself, man. So the competitiveness is really, really awesome, and it makes it super fun. We have an app now that I'm starting to use, log in your workouts, you go in there, you check out who's like in first place, second place, or whatever. And a lot of times it's not more like, oh, I need to get better and beat them. It's more of like a, damn, they're really good, I need to step my stuff up and keep working hard. So the competitiveness, man, that's really awesome. Just embrace it and just learn to love it, man. Another part of the little community aspect of it, which I love. Hey, let's talk about topic number two, which is the physical gains, physical transformation. So February of this year, 2019, I started CrossFit, and I started it by going maybe a few days a week and then the rest just normal gym, and then I started going CrossFit every day and then also the normal gym every day, and just got to the point where I was like, you know what, I'm enjoying CrossFit more, I'm only gonna do CrossFit now. So I've been doing only CrossFit now for about 6 months. Physically, I can breathe more, my endurance has gone up, I don't feel like I've lost any muscle mass. Honestly, my endurance has gone up, I can breathe more, I've gotten stronger, and I can jump higher. So I feel like every aspect is going up, and it's crazy to say that because sometimes I'm like, oh, we haven't practiced this movement in a long time, and we've been doing like a bunch of other exercises, let's say for like an overhead squat. Oh, we have an overhead squat in a few weeks, probably a month. And we've been doing a lot of overhead stuff with either kettlebells or dumbbells, that sort of thing. And then the overhead squats get thrown in there, and I actually PB or PR my lift, and it feels really good. My movement, like my mobility's good, and it just feels good. So like little things like that kind of give you that reassurance, like, hey, like I'm still progressing, I'm getting stronger, keep trusting the process, that sort of thing. Personally, I think I look better now. I think my endurance is definitely gone up. I can breathe a lot more. I can move a lot better. I'm more flexible and mobile than I was before. Another big reason why I got into functional fitness and wanted to do CrossFit for the mobility aspect, I just felt super stiff all the time. Felt like a robot, and I did not like that feeling. I've always been athletic. I've always been active growing up as a kid. So having that, being able to like run and stuff and jump and all these sort of things was really a big pro for me. My endurance has gone up. I feel like I physically look better, and I've gotten stronger as well in all my lifts, which has been awesome, man. That's always the goal, is to try to keep getting better, keep progressing. So from a physical standpoint, it's definitely been nothing but pros, and it's gone up. Obviously, there's been times where I've been super sore and beat up, and I'm like, oh, what the heck? But I've just learned to like love it and embrace it, and obviously listen to my body a lot more. It's helped me listen to how my body reacts to different types of workouts and stimulus, and also different types of foods, which we'll get into in a little bit here with the nutrition side of things. So in the past, I, you know, taking a rest day or an active rest day was kind of like, what the heck? Like, I would not take one. I just keep working out or something 7 days a week. With CrossFit, man, I do not mind taking a rest day, maybe two active rest days, or maybe even, you know, one midweek and one at the end of the week, or maybe even one full rest day and one active rest day, man. I don't feel guilty. I feel good about it because I know that I've been pushing myself, that I'm getting better, and that active rest day or that actual full rest day is actually gonna push me further into, you know, just getting better and just recovering and just leading into better workouts, essentially. Let's talk about the nutrition side of things. Nutrition-wise, I've always counted macros in the past. I've done intermittent fasting. I've never done keto, but the nutrition was always kind of like the iffy part. I've always had that mentality of try to keep it simple, not overthink things, because I am definitely a thinker. So the more I simplify things, the better. Keeping it stupid simple, man. My whole mentality just throughout, you know, ever since I started working out and kind of like learning how to eat, was eat clean, train mean. I've tracked macros in the past, and I've, you know, like cut and I've bulked and done that whole sort of jazz, and it's been good. But one thing was kind of just being restricted on foods. Ever since I started functional fitness and CrossFit, I've been eating the most I've ever ate. And honestly, like, I don't feel the need to eat like shit. Rather than whenever I was cutting or bulking, I always wanted just to, like, I always craved like the super bad foods or ate like shit. Whereas now I'm eating a ton of food, which is probably also why I'm probably not craving bad foods, because I'm full. So I'm just eating a lot of clean foods, a lot of veggies, a lot of clean proteins, healthy fats, carbs, that sort of thing. But also, I'm enjoying myself. I'm not really counting macros. I did a little 6-week mini cut and I counted macros. It was fun just to get back in the groove, but then I stopped again, just kind of going with intuitive eating. I feel good about what I'm eating. It's the foods that I enjoy. It's clean. They make me feel good. And I always have that thought in the back of my head, like, okay, what is this that's going in my body right now? Is it going to help me or is it going to hurt me? And then also just enjoying myself too. Like whenever I want a pizza or something like that, pizza or like maybe like a chocolate chip cookie, that is my downfall, man. I'll go and have one, man. Like, but I don't go overboard, because I would in the past where you just crush an entire pizza. It's like, oh, I'm really craving pizza, man, I'll probably go have like a slice or two. Or if I decide to have like an active rest day and I'll have like a cheat meal, I don't really call it a cheat meal. I just go out and treat myself to a meal that I've been wanting throughout the whole week. And if I've been going hard and pushing myself that week, I feel good about enjoying that meal that I normally wouldn't have. Like, let's say it's pizza and wings or burger and fries, like those sorts of things that I do enjoy and that do keep me sane, and you should too. Gotta have that balance, man. I personally love food. I don't know about you, but I love food. But yeah, nutrition-wise, it's awesome. Just eating more, and I'm looking better than I have before. And also feeling better. Like, I feel better. I can move. I can jump. My energy level's up. Also, since starting CrossFit, I've been off of caffeine for about 2 months now. So what I've been doing is going on a run either early morning to wake me up and kind of get the blood flowing, and I'll use that as my pre-workout, man. I found that really just helps me. But yeah, no caffeine too, and just trying to really find, like, clean energy levels and looking good, feeling good.
good and just being able to move good, which has been huge, man. So the nutrition part of things is a big up. When I first started, a lot of people say, oh, you can just eat whatever during CrossFit. I mean, I'm sure you can, but I personally feel better when I'm eating clean. I feel better about myself. I feel better energy wise. And also I feel better whenever I do decide to, because I'm in this for the long haul. I'm all about the health side of things, nutrition side of things, and eating clean and then really enjoying a meal at the end of the week or whenever I feel like, oh, I've been really craving this, wanting this, I allow myself to, and it feels way better. I enjoy it a lot more, and I can enjoy it with either family or friends, man. And that's what it's about. It's enjoying those little moments with your loved ones. That's another thing that's been awesome with CrossFit. I feel like it's really brought me more together with people, like family, friends, and just the whole community in the box as well. Let's get into that last part, which is overall satisfaction of CrossFit. Starting CrossFit in 2019, in 2020, in 2021, whatever year it is, I say go for it, man. Give it a shot. I tried it a few months before I actually started going to CrossFit full time. And the first few times I was like, I love this and I hate this. The next few times I was like, why the hell am I doing this? And then you just kind of, it's a snowball effect, man. You start to love it and you start to feel really like the way you feel after the workouts. You start to feel the way you're looking. You start to like the way you're feeling about your body and how you can move and like these different things that carry on into other aspects of life, like your mentality, that community aspect, and just like really like being kind to people, pushing them, wanting to see them thrive as well and prosper alongside you. And then also just like your mentality on food and stuff and family and just, I don't know, it's just like a overall satisfaction of CrossFit is, I would say 10 out of 10 for sure. Starting CrossFit in 2019, 6 months in, has been one of the best decisions I've ever made. I'm having so much fun with my training, even though it sucks a lot of the time. It sucks in terms of like it hurts, it's hard. But hey man, I actually just told my mom this, who's just now getting into fitness and eating clean. I told her I was super sore. She's like, but you work out every day. I said, it doesn't get easier, you just get stronger. Being sore is a good thing. You gotta embrace it, like it hurts so good now. But overall satisfaction, best decision I've made up to this point. Other than just like starting my health and fitness journey back in like 8th, 9th grade, whenever I was just a chubby little kid, and then I lost a lot of weight and then I was super skinny and then trying to gain muscle. So I've been on both ends, man. You guys aren't alone. If you have any questions, hit the link below, apply for my one-on-one coaching, or just shoot me a DM over on Instagram or in the comments below, man. I'm always here to help. But overall satisfaction of CrossFit, 10 out of 10, one of the best decisions I've ever made. If you're on the verge of starting CrossFit, I highly recommend you do. Like I said, for the community aspect, the mental gains you're gonna make, the physical gains you're gonna make, and then just overall just well-being and satisfaction, man. You're in there, you're working out with other people, you're pushing you to get better. A lot of times people lack motivation, so that's good if you can find motivation with other people. And yeah, so would I recommend you starting CrossFit? Yes. Would I go back 6 months and not have started CrossFit? No. If I could go back a year from now, would I have started CrossFit? Yes. But also yes, I would say yes. But also just keep working on the fundamentals. I took a long time to just keep working on fundamentals such as like power cleans, deadlifts, squats, different overhead stuff. And then I jumped into actual CrossFit. But yeah, man, I'm 6 months in, still got a lot of room to improve and a lot of gains to be made, man. So I'm super excited to be documenting my journey here alongside you guys. Breakfast Club, Crave the Grind, that's my clothing brand / motto / saying. Let's go, man, new to CrossFit. I'm so happy. If you guys are watching this now, I'm so excited to have you guys following along my journey, this new to CrossFit journey. There's many more to come, for the rest of the few months, years to come, man. I'm super excited for you guys to be following along and to see all the progress we can make, both on this YouTube channel, both mentally, physically, and spiritually, man. That's what this is all about, is getting better, me sharing my journey, my experiences with you, me learning from stuff and then sharing that to you guys as well, and just going along this journey together. If you're new to CrossFit or you want to start CrossFit, have any questions for me, drop them below in the comments. Head over to Instagram, shots_G, follow me there, DM me, man. I'm so excited to be building this little community around what I'm doing, and then also you guys, you know, if you're new to CrossFit or just getting into health and fitness overall. But yeah, Breakfast Club, CTG, we out. I read the whole workout completely wrong. I ended up doing more reps than I should have. I initially was gonna do half the weight of level one in my gym, which is the RX or prescribed level, which is level one. That level was 60 with a partner, so that means drop it down to half if you're by yourself. I've looked at the level two scoreboard and it was 40 hang power cleans, 40 shoulder press, 20 sink rows, burpees, 20 toes to bar. At 95, I saw the 95 and I just automatically figured it was like 40. So I did 40 all the way through. So I ended up going 40 hang power cleans, 40 shoulder to overhead, 20 burpees,
and 20 knees to elbow on the rings. So, I don't know, man. Got super messed up. It felt good, man. I'm pumped about that. This was a fun workout, man. Give it a go. It was hard for sure. My time was right around 20, 25. That's with me running over here and missing the button the first time. So probably a few seconds shorter than that, maybe like 20, maybe 20-20. But yeah, man, that was good. I didn't do the toaster bar just because I'm not efficient at those. I get the first one down and then the rhythm's just messed up, which is what I wanted to practice today, hopefully. I saw some pointers up on Instagram by Ryan Fisher. It was a really good tutorial teaching you how to like kind of get the rhythm down. And then if you mess one up, a good way to bounce back into it without having to like drop yourself, which is good. I'm gonna practice those, man. But that was a good workout. Yeah, did more than I thought. I did more than I thought that I was supposed to do, but yeah, man, overall, it's a good workout. Can't complain if you're getting more reps and more work. So that was a good one, man. Breakfast Club CTG, we out to speed.